Well, you look outside, it's January, it's freezing cold, and it's almost zero, and you say, hey, this is the time to think about your garden. Well, that's what Fran Blank from Don Molds is telling me today, because you really sort of have to plan to have the right kind of garden, the garden that's going to be successful.
Exactly. I try to get people to start thinking now about what they want to grow in their garden by thinking about end use. So what do you want to end up with?
And what time of the season and all that sort of thing.
Right. So I brought a lot of seed catalogs. This is the time to start thinking about getting your seed catalogs. Mine start coming before Thanksgiving, and they pile up and pile up so I can peruse them whenever I want.
Well, you're a crazy seed lady.
I am
right?
a crazy seed lady.
So if people look at this and they say, I can't read all that stuff. How do you sort it out to get down to one place?
You sort it out by thinking about what your end use is. Like on this, a lot of these, they'll say, remember I was here before and we talked about determinate and indeterminate tomatoes. If you want tomatoes just for fresh eating, mm-hmm. you want to pick them and eat them, yum, in the summertime, then think about maybe a determinate tomato that has, that you pick, makes its fruit, and then it's pretty much done.
Oh, okay, so it bears a fruit and then it's over.
And then
over.
It's pretty much done. The other one is an indeterminate tomato, which I'm always talking about, but that'll bear and bear and bear and bear. So if you want fresh eating, you might want an indeterminate that'll bear
so
all summer.
So that's really for your salads and all that stuff.
Right.
But I guess if you want, say you want to have a canning season, you probably want a tomato where they all show up at the same time.
Which is a determinate tomato. And these are, this was a determinate tomato. This was a San Marzano canning tomato. So when you're reading the catalogs.
San Marzano's that great Italian
right,
plum tomato.
Fabulous plum tomato. Nice and thick walled. It makes nice tomato sauce, which is what this is. Look at the seed catalogs or the seed packets, and they'll tell you this is a great canning tomato, mm-hmm. or this is a great dehydrating tomato. This is a Princip Borghese, a little Italian tomato about that big that dries beautifully.
So it has to have like thick walls so the and be sort of a dry one.
Right, not too much moisture, right, and it dries beautifully. In Italy, they grow those and pick them and just hang them on fences, and they dry, and they're beautiful.
Just in the sun.
Just in the sun.
Guys,
which
beautiful.
We can't do by the lake. We can't
do
that.
We need
you might also think about something like a paprika pepper, and this is one from my garden. This is a bulldog, B-O-L-D-O-G, bulldog, that I grow, mm-hmm. dry, and then store just like this. And when I want fresh paprika, I can just
grind it.
I grind it in a little coffee grinder.
Does that have a lot more flavor,
oh,
right?
Oh, it's wonderful.
It sounds really good to me. And this pepper, how do you dry these?
I have a dehydrator, but you can also simply throw them in a bag and just hang them up and let them dry. That'll be fine.
Where'd you buy the onions?
The onions are from my garden, and they're stored. They're in storage in my basement. Again, when you're picking seeds, if you want things to store, if you want onions to store, mm-hmm. you need to buy a long day onion. This is important. There are short day onions mm-hmm. for the South. Long day onions. You want a long day storage onion. These were picked in my garden in early August, cured in. I still have them.
You said cured. So how do you cure that? And what do
I
you do?
Pick them, pull them, mm-hmm. tie about 12 together, and hang them up over, out of the wind, out of the sun, out of the rain.
Can you do it in the garage then?
You could do it in the garage from the rafters.
How about
beautiful.
The basement? What can you do in the basement?
You don't want too much. No, it needs to be outside with some air circulation. Dry.
You get that dry, papery protection.
Right. What you want to do with the storage onion is get the top to dry really tight.
Got it.
And then it'll store the onion.
And what's going on over here?
Yeah, this is something else you could look for when you're picking your seeds. This is a winter. These are winter mixes, and these are greens that I grow in my basement, which is a really cold farmhouse basement. And this one is just called Wild Garden, and this one's called Winter Brown. And these grow under fluorescent lights in my basement.
You put them under lights. And these are ready to harvest right now, huh?
I will cut these today.
And these are good ones to put in the garden so you can pick them and they keep coming back.
But these are specifically for cold weather. Mm-hmm. You can buy cold weather lettuce, you can buy warm weather lettuce seeds. So be particular when you're reading the catalogs about what you want. One other real quick thing is when your seeds come, you place your orders, they come in the mail, get a nice jar that closes tightly and put in the bottom some desiccants.
Okey-doke.
They come from, aspirin or purses and boots. Put that in the bottom. Put your seeds down in there and then put this jar in the refrigerator.
Okay,
and
great.
Your seeds will store
beautifully. I've got another segment ready to blossom over here right now. So I'll tell everybody, go to Don Molds Plantation, look for Fran. She can help walk you through this. Right, Natalie?
Both stores.